Good evening. Today we're going to do the poem Women's Work by Julia Alvarez. So this poem is something that opens the subject of domestic role of women in family life. So here we have the poetess telling us the story of her mother. How her mother was obsessed with housekeeping and how that influenced her future life, right? So Julia Alvarez was an American who was born in New York, but she spent her early life in the Dominican Republic, which is her mother worked with the UN, but later on they came back to America and settled there. So her formative years or her initial years, or maybe we can say her childhood years, were in the Dominican Republic. So we find her, most of her works that she has presented, we find her caught between both these cultures, the culture of America and the culture of the Dominican Republic. So we see how her experiences of living between these two cultural worlds is depicted in her work. Now, in this particular poem, you can say that she depicts and she also criticizes her mother's active domestic role, but she admits that this role or whatever her mother did influenced her in becoming a woman working at home herself, right? So that is what this poem is all about. She speaks about how her mother was so much involved in domestic chores, right? And this is actually, when you talk about the subject of the poem, we understand that it just speaks about the importance of woman housekeeping, or you know, how a woman keeps the house. And because she was raised in the Dominican Republic at a time where most women did not work outside the home, and women raised their daughters to be housewives, we can see that particular subject very much prevalent in this poem. And see, as I told you, they later went back to New York, and they had to flee Dominican Republic because there was a dictator named Trujillo in Dominican Republic, and her parents or her family supported an unsuccessful attempt to overthrow this dictator, and they had to leave the country. So they came back to New York, and there she published her first novel in 1991, titled How the Garcia Girls Lost Their Accents. And this was a commercial success, right? And in this particular poem, we see how the mother is forced to do all the household cleaning. That represents the domestic life and the impact of gender specific roles. So this poem, as we read, we understand that this is written from the third person point of view. And the speaker or the poetess is the daughter of a mother who does work outside. As I told you, she was working with the UN, and but she was a person who was so fanatic about doing her household cleaning, right? And she forces her daughter also to do it. And you know, we see how Julia Alvarez, or the poetess, is not very happy as a child, because she can hear the sounds of her friends playing outside in the street, right? And so she uses, you know, we see that how Julia Alvarez uses imagery, she uses simile, she uses alliteration to portray the meaning of this poem and show or depict to society that women work harder than men. So the conflict in the poem is that women do all the jobs inside the house, and also sometimes they work outside. Whereas the men go out and work, and they expect the women to have done everything in the house, everything, dinner ready, floors wiped, laundry cleaned, everything. So this is the conflict that we see in this particular poem. So what I'll do, I'll just read the poem for you. You can just listen to the poem, and after you listen to the poem, we'll just see how the analysis of the poem is. Right? Okay. Women's work. Who says a woman's work isn't high art? She challenged as she scrubbed the bathroom tiles. Keep the house as if the address were your heart. We'd clean the whole upstairs before we'd start downstairs. I'd sigh, hearing my friends outside doing her woman's work was a hard art. To practice when the summer sun would bar the floor, I swept till she was satisfied. She kept me prisoner in a house-bound heart. She'll shine the tines of fox, the wheels of carts, cut lacy lattices for all her pies. A woman's work was nothing less than art. And I, her masterpiece, since I was smart, was primed, praised, polished, scolded, and advised to keep a house much better than my heart. I did not want to be her counterpart. I struck out, but became my mother's child, a woman working at home on her art, housekeeping paper as if it were her heart. So this is the poem. I'll just read it once more. You can listen to it more carefully. Who says a woman's work isn't high art? She challenged as she scrubbed the bathroom tiles. Keep house as if the address were your heart. We'd clean the whole upstairs before we'd start downstairs. I'd sigh hearing my friends outside. Doing a woman's work was a hard art to practice. When the summer sun would bar the floor, I swept till she was satisfied. She kept me prisoner in a housebound heart. She'd shine the tines of a fox, the wheels of the carts, cut lazy lattices for all her pies. Her woman's work was nothing less than art. And I, her masterpiece, since I was smart, was primed, praised, polished, scolded, and advised to keep a house much better than my heart. I did not want to be her counterpart. I struck out, but became my mother's child, a woman working at home on her art, housekeeping paper as if it were her heart. So this is the poem, right? So here we see the daughter or the protagonist or the poetess or the speaker of the poem starting with a rhetoric question, right? Who says a woman's work isn't high art? So this was probably one of her mother's favorite phrases while she performed her domestic chores. See, her mother says, who says a woman's work isn't high art? She calls it high art. She challenged as she scrubbed the bathroom tiles. So as the mother was doing the bathroom tiles or cleaning the bathroom tiles, she would tell her daughter, who says a woman's work isn't high art? It's not a kind of domestic chore. It is an art. And she says, keep house as if the address were your heart. So the last line of this first answer could be addressed to the father, or maybe to the speaker, or to the whole family. So what she means here is the hearts, their hearts, embody the address of the house which her mother cared for. What it means here is the mother's care and love was embodied in the household chores. She did not do it as drudgery. She enjoyed doing it. There was so much of love and care into what she did, right? And as I said, the mother was employed. We are not very sure, because when we read Julia Alvarez's blog, we understand that her mother was employed with the UN. But that's not, we are not very sure about, because some of the critics, in her official site, her mother was the alternative representative to the UN with the Dominican mission. But many critics say that she did not work. Anyway, what I feel is she might have been working. At the same time, she might have been a very fervent housewife, right? So she was one person who enjoyed doing her work. That is why she calls even scrubbing bathroom tiles high art, right? Or she says, you know, woman's work is high art, right? So though she was employed, or though she had a part-time job, it might not have been a full-time job, though she had a part-time job, she focused all her attention to keeping a perfect house. Right? And she made her daughter also do the work. So this daughter was engaged in doing the woman's work from a very early age. And this daughter was very frustrated to hear her friends play outside while she was obliged to clean the house. See, she says, we'd clean the whole upstairs before we'd start downstairs. I'd sigh hearing my friends outside. Right? And she says, doing her woman's work was hard art. And what does the mother say? Mother say it's high art, right? The mother calls woman's work high art, whereas the speaker, the daughter, calls it hard art, right? So this daughter was concentrating merely on domestic chores, and that made her very unhappy, right? And as she grew up, she started complaining about her mother's strictness and obsession with keeping the house clean. That's why she says, doing her woman's work was hard art to practice. When the summer sun would bar the floor, I swept till she was satisfied. See, And she says she kept me prisoner in a housebound heart. So she says, you know, her mother was one person who was so obsessed with cleaning. And her mother loved it. Whereas the daughter did not love it much. She just concentrated on doing the chores and just getting over with it. But she also goes on to say something. Though she did not like the routine of housekeeping, though the daughter did not like the routine of housekeeping, she had to admit the fact that her mother was a very artful housewife. That's what she says. She'd shine the tines of forks. The tines of forks are the prongs, you know, the prongs of the fork that spear the food that you eat. So she'd shine. She'd make sure that the tines of the forks were very clean and shining. The wheels of carts, she would cut lacy lattices. Lacy lattices would be a knitted cloth or an oil paper to spread the dough for baking the pies, right? So she was like, you know, she used to cut lacy lattices. So it's not that her mother simply did it or she did not enjoy it. Her mother really enjoyed it. She was a very good housekeeper. So her woman's work was nothing less than art. That's what she says. She admits that her mother's work was nothing less than art. And she says, I, her masterpiece, since I was smart, was primed, praised, polished, scolded, and advised to keep a house much better than my heart. And she says, you know, her mother considered her her masterpiece because she was very witty. She was very smart. She felt her mother's love and care through all kinds of attention. And her mother always advised her and instructed her to keep her house better than her personal life. That she says, to keep a house much better than my heart, right? So eventually what happened? She did not want to become her mother's counterpart, right? She says, I did not want to be her counterpart, right? So a counterpart is a person who corresponds or fulfills the same function, but in a different situation, right? So she did not want to be her mother's counterpart. But what happened? She says, I struck out but became my mother's child, a woman working at home on her art. You know, she says, eventually, though she was tired of her constant dutiful housekeeping, she never wanted to be her mother's counterpart. What happens is, she ended up working at home, creating, writing poems and loving her housebound creative work, right? So she says, a woman working at home on her art, housekeeping paper as if it were her heart. So, you know, she started sitting at home and working. She started creating and she started loving her housebound creative work. So here we see that Julia Alvarez is very good at literary images because she has already caught her imagination. We have started drawing pictures of a housewife who cares a great deal about keeping a perfect house. So when we read this, we have an image, right? So to depict the artful but hard work her mother used to perform, see, Julia Alvarez uses powerful descriptions. She says, scrub the bathroom tiles. She'd shine the tines of forks, the wheels of carts. She would cut lacy lattices for her pies. From these descriptions, we understand that this woman, Julia Alvarez's mother, was a very scrupulous woman who cared for every inch of her house and who wanted to keep it really clean, right? So, and the author also addresses the theme of heart, which stands for the symbol of love and relationships. In the first stanza, you see, the heart, keep house as if the address were your heart. In the first stanza, it can be the father's heart or her own heart, whatever. The heart of the family is compared to the house her mother cared about. So the following allusion actually talks about the speaker's private life, feelings and relationships, and she ultimately comes to writing. That was her greatest love, you know. So in the end, in the denouement, we see how she speaks about writing, housekeeping paper. She says housekeeping paper as if it were her heart. So when we read Julia Alvarez's official site, we understand that her mother served the UN with the Dominican mission, right? But at the same time, we also understand that she was a very dutiful housewife, a person who looked. Here we see how the author depicts, and she uses a lot of images, and the images that she uses enables the readers to interpret the messages hidden between the lines using their own imagination. So she says, you know, there's one stanza when she says, doing a woman's work was a hard art to practice. When the summer sun would bar the floor, I swept till she was satisfied. Now, when the summer sun would bar the floor, it draws a beautiful picture of an evening, implying that the daughter would sweep the floor till late and was satisfied. See, the other one, a woman working at home on her art, housekeeping paper as if it were a heart. Housekeeping paper is another example of the literary language that Julia Alvarez uses to name her future career, right? So she has been very much influenced by her mother's activities. Her mother, she actually criticized her mother initially, but we understand how that has influenced her life. She has made a great work describing how the mother's obsessive housekeeping and playing merely domestic role influences her life of the younger women in the family. So this poem reveals just how hard it is to be a woman keeping house. You know, people sometimes forget that women have nothing to do. People always feel that women have nothing to do. People sometimes forget that women simply that women find it very difficult to do their work. They always feel that women have it easy while the men have it rough, right? So, but we have always heard a woman's work is never done, right? So today, many women work. In those days, during the time of Julia Alvarez, she lived in a time where women did not work much. They did not go out to work. But today we see women make up a significant portion of the workforce, right? But even then, they come back and make sure that the house is in order. They are actually responsible for the house. It's always, society, we see society looking up to women to fulfill the needs of taking care of the house, right? So it is hard work taking care of a house. You know, you've got so many things to do. You have to do the clothes, the dinner, you have to do the sweeping, swap, mopping, dishes. It's just one list. Plus, we have so much of other work to do. So here we see Julia Alvarez, or the speaker, is a very young girl. She's helping her mother clean the house. She's very frustrated. Why? Because she wants to be outside enjoying her childhood. But she's kept in her mother's prison. She's made to sweep the floor, and she has to do it till her mother approves of it. So the mother is repeating the cycle by teaching her daughter to clean at such an early age. So this could be, you can just construe as part of a culture that is not to be questioned by the young. In other words, we understand that the mother knows what's best. See, the girl cannot question her. The girl wants to go out, but she's not able to question her. Because, we understand that the mother knows what's best. And towards the end, the girl is determined not to have the same fate as her mother. But what happens is, she comes out the same way, focusing on her aunt at home. So here, we see this woman is a very subservient wife. She pays very much, a lot of attention to cleaning a house. And instead of her own self, And her husband is not mentioned anywhere in the poem. She's spending all the time. She's happy, or whether she's content in the position of the household, right? So sometimes we feel that women are treated like second-class citizens in their own home. And it should actually cease. Today we always feel that a woman is capable of doing both things, balancing her family, balancing her career, right? Doing things which would actually focus on both, focus on her career, focus on the house, right? But still, society always believes that a woman's place is at home. She has to keep the house. She has to raise the children. There's nothing wrong with that. But it is a position that should be given respect, and she should be treated equally. I say treated with equality, right? And see, as I told you, though she was born in New York City to Dominican parents, she had moved to Dominican Republic, and she has contributed a lot of to several poems and novels in the literary community, right? And she has used her advantage as a Dominican American to provide different perspectives, because you see, both the cultural ambience evident in her work. So the cultural worlds, the two different cultural worlds, because she was born in New York, her parents were Dominican, But then they moved to Dominican Republic, but later on, because they decided to stand with the community that wanted to overthrow the dictator, they had to rush back to, or they had to flee Dominican Republic and come back to America. So this, both these cultural worlds are depicted in her writing, right? So, and in this particular poem, we understand that Julia Alvarez is also showing us importance of the house, of housekeeping, right? And she portrays this woman who is always cleaning, representing a domestic life, the impact of gender-specific role, right? So you can see her using imagery, simile, alliteration to portray the meaning of the poem that women work harder than men, right? So imagery is used to represent objects, actions, ideas in such a way that it appeals to our physical senses. So in the, you can look at line three, you know. In line three, she says, keep house as if the address were your heart. It basically means to keep the memories of the home in the heart, right? Memories of the households are so special and it should never be forgotten. But the word your, see, keep house as if the address were your heart. The word your is used to symbolize maybe the father as someone special to the house or the family. And the daughter shows that the dad is never around the house and he leaves all the housework to the mother and herself, since she is helping the mother. So the dad being someone special shows that he has power and control in the house that represents a domestic life for the mother and daughter. Another literary device that Julia Alvarez uses is alliteration. Alliteration is commonly used because it adds interest to a sentence and can be a great way to help you remember something that you might forget. You look at these lines, and I, her masterpiece, since I was smart, was primed, praised, polished, right? Primed, praised, polished, scolded, and advised to keep a house much better than my heart. The letter P, see the letter P, sorry, the sound P, primed, praised, polished, right? Here, this is alliteration, and those were the goals she had to follow and tried to achieve that also, right? So the significance of the poem's title is dealing with women and them doing chores. Women's work, that's how this title is. If a woman likes house cleaning, it becomes something very beautiful. But if someone other than herself uses it to have power over them, the person starts to feel as if they're in prison. That's what she says, you know. She felt as though she was in prison, as though they're in prison, have no freedom, have no set of power. And I feel that this is basically about today's society. Women today are set to play a role in the family as a wife, a mother. Mother cleans, cooks, and this shows the importance of a household woman housekeeping. So sometimes in certain homes, we feel women are forced to do household chores. And we don't see men helping out. But that should change. Housekeeping is the most important part of a woman's life, according to the poem, right? But the message that we want to send out is household chores should be divided among everyone according to their abilities so that everyone is responsible. Everyone learns new skills. Everyone can take care of themselves and respect their house. This is very important. So that is why Julia Alvarez has used these literary devices to express the fact that women work harder than men. But even though women work harder than men, we should come to a situation where men, not only men, even children share the household chores. Because it is only then that people learn to be responsible and people learn to consider the home as their own. Otherwise, what happens is it just lies with one person. So that is how, that is why Julia Alvarez is trying to, that's what she's trying to bring out through this poem. So, you know, the cozy living spaces, you know, the homes, right? This becomes the primary occupation of every woman because they invest major part of their life and time for this, right? So it's not just, a woman who's working outside is not just doing that. When she comes home, she has to work at home also. It's a kind of round-the-clock work for women. And they are most of the time unsung warriors, right? And here, she's trying to express how women work so sincerely and with so much of commitment to make houses into homes. We've always talked about the dictum, men build houses, women build homes. So women actually work round the clock. They're unsung warriors. They work round the clock and they work with so much of dedication and sincerity, and they create comfortable living spaces called homes. So when you look forward to come back to home after a hard day, always remember that it is a woman's hand, a heart that builds these homes. So if you need a comfortable, cozy space, there's a woman's hand behind. That is what Julia Alvarez is trying to portray through this poem. Okay, I hope this is clear. Do you have any questions or any doubts? You can ask me now.